Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Zombie Gaming here again, and welcome back to another episode of Cube World. Give me one second, I'm going to turn down my render distance just a little bit. Just because, I don't know, reduce lag. So welcome back, everybody. I'm so sorry last episode was quiet, but I am finally back with my voice today. And just got into the city. And don't worry, I did manage to do some stuff off camera, such as getting some 14 ginseng soup, 2 mushroom spit, and 12 life potions. So that's always good. And it looks like it is about to become nighttime very, very soon. So I could reset it today and get it, you know, all bright again. But I kind of want to make this a nighttime episode, show you guys what it's like. So, yeah. We're going to actually do some stuff in town because, you know, we always got to make our stops to town occasionally. Do we have any leftovers? I just want to save the trip. Nope. Okay. Alrighty. Actually, let's visit the loom place. I think that's this way. I'm just looking at the mini-map here. I think it's the place with the scissors. Yeah, this is it. I want to see if we can make silk yarn from these cobwebs. I don't know if you can. Is this silk yarn? Requires spinning wheel. And I think this is a spinning wheel. Yeah. Silk yarn from cobwebs. Yep, I was right. So this is how we make armor. I don't think you can get fortune on this, so that kind of sucks. But fortune is just, you know. Oh, we actually did. So when you there's a random chance you can get more than one of what you're making. So let's see what armor we can make. Requires workbench. I don't have any wood cubes, though. Wood wand. I might damage 9.7. That's a lot better. With some other cool stats. Okay, so, we can make that. We just need some wood cubes, which is, used by destroying bushes where you can get wood. Do we already have some wood? I think we do. Yeah, 7 wood. The sawmill is this way, so let's go head over there. And if you guys don't, like, with my other character, the Rogue, for Season 2, I didn't give you guys really a chance to see the city, but if you're a beginning character, you will definitely, see just kind of how the city works. We get enough for that? We got 9. But I think we do need a little bit more. So I'm just going to look at these shops, see if we can buy any weapons that would be better. So the damage on that other staff that we wanted was at 9.7. That's for Ranger. How much is this? Power 5 adapted. Your power 10. There's a wand. I kind of want to stick with the staffs, to be honest. Where are all the staffs? Okay, yeah, those are too high level, so maybe. Because this one that we have now is power 1. So, I think maybe we can just go with this one. Did we just get it? Yes, we did. So that's going to put our weapon rating up to 91%. That's awesome. Now, let's see what we can. I'll go to. Actually, let's sell some stuff. Oh, that's silk armor that we want. We want to keep our mage stuff. Oh yeah, I forgot we got those the rings. And I did do a little bit off camera, so when we use one, it uses all the MP we have and it heals us. So if I want to switch to say these rings, which I really like the attacks on that, but it. The armor rating, or the weapon rating, is currently not as good, so we're gonna stick with our staff. Just because, you know, it's a lot better than what we have. So, let's take a look at, I guess, the potion shop, because I did make a couple potions, but I think it'd be nice to have some more. fill up on potions and stuff for our later battles, because as a beginning character, we will definitely need those. We'll just fill up on these. Okay, there we go. Awesome. So we filled up on those. I don't think we need anything else there. Let's go visit the armor shop really quick, because that is something we do need. We don't have any armor. Let's just check out the shop. See what they got for us today. There's the entrance. I was beginning to worry. I was like, wait, where's the entrance? Okay, we need silk stuff. Dusty silk boots. Why not? We need silk gloves. Why not? Nope, that's too expensive. Let's just go with the boots for now. So now our feet are red. We got our silk boots. That's really all we can get. But that is A-okay. Now, I did want to look for a well really quick, so I can finish crafting up potions. I remember at the end of last episode, I was full up on heart flowers, but I did make those 12, so I have room to get some more. So let's just look around for more, or for a well, just to get potions, and then I think that will do it, because we got these boots, which put our armor rating at 17%, and we still have the wand and the bracelets, but they don't do as much damage as our staff, so we're gonna stick with that for now. This staff looks really like this one Lego piece that I know. I don't know why, it looks very similar to this kind of Lego brick, so I always think of that whenever I see a staff like this. Kind of funny. And I mean, you gotta expect some similarities from like this to Legos to Minecraft, all those voxel kind of things, just because somewhere in the voxel-based graphics, you're gonna have some similarities. You gotta expect that from time to time. Now, if only we could find a well. Can we find a well? Or any kind of water, for that matter. I don't see any rivers in the mini-map nearby. So, well might be our best bet for water as of now. There's a heart flower I can go grab. But I think, in the inns, you can also sleep. So, if I go into this inn right here, I'm gonna sleep and make it a little bit... Well, nah, we'll just keep looking for the well to make it darker. But if you sleep, you can regenerate health, but it takes longer to, or it speeds up time, so you regenerate health, but it speeds up time. So if you want it to be nighttime, you can very well do that by just sleeping in a bed, because that'll do the trick. Okay. And actually, I did level up another time, so I put 2 more points into our healing stream, so that's really good. I think that's going to be really helpful if I switch weapons, because I was talking to Danny, and he was a mage, if you guys did not see him in some past episodes of Season 1 and Season 2. He is a mage, so that means he just told me the rings are really good. So we're going to try those out once we can, you know, get some practice with this staff. We'll switch on to a new weapon. I am not finding well. Directly behind us, there's a river I saw in the map, so I'm just gonna go there, because water is definitely a necessity. And nighttime does get slightly creepy just because of how dark it is, but there's no more increase of mobs, there's no more, you know, harder enemies. It's the same basic stuff. But let's craft up all these water flasks, because we definitely need these. And this is the basic way to get potions. And our healing stream is really going to help for when we're out of them. But it's always good to stay stocked up on supplies. You don't have to spam click, you just have to hold, and it does this. I don't know why, but when I'm doing a new character, I feel like revisiting the basics, just kind of revisiting the controls and stuff. Just so you guys know about it. And I think we're just gonna leave it at the water flasks. I just wanted to get a little bit stocked up, Because we're already sitting okay on potions, and I do want to see how well the healing stream works in battle. Because I think that'd be really cool. So even if you're holding it, if you move it off, then... But actually, if you do that, I showed this trick earlier, if you're still holding it. Okay, awesome. So, wow, this river was generated weird. So, now that it's nighttime, we can head off in any direction we want to. I think this way is best, just straight southwest, because that's a way we haven't explored yet. This will be an awesome way to show you guys the nighttime. I'm going to turn on my light, just so there is some visibility there. But as I told you guys, I did do some off-camera work and I got to level 3, so that's always good. I literally killed like 3 flies, and I got to level 3 because we were so close. Is it gonna be a battle? This is a battle. Oh, you got owned. Why are you dropping warrior stuff? That's stuff for me, man! You gotta be dropping mage stuff. But man, I've always loved these, like, cubes as leaves. It's so cool. But really, playing as a new character again is... brings back that nostalgia of the first day I bought this game. I was so excited. Because I watched B00 play it. I was like, man, it's so cool. And we can't forget what else we're out here for is, those bushes. We need to get some logs. Because we need to... I think it'd be cool to be able to craft some more wooden items. And there's a band of marauding. I don't know. I'll call them marauding if they're evil. If they're evil, I'm probably... Okay, good. They're okay. Let's cook up some ginseng soup over here. And the fire in the campfires, you cannot... Hi, everybody. You cannot get fortune in the campfires. Some rocks can be destroyed with bombs. Cyclopses exist. I know cyclopses exist. But if you guys saw in the, I don't like hiking. I prefer riding.
I do too.
But if you guys saw last episode, this guy was talking about snow golems. And I was like, what? Those don't exist. And I don't know, maybe you guys put in the comments because there was no commentary last episode. You probably are the best climber in Cube World. Wow, that's impressive. Props to you, bro. But yeah, I was like confused. I mean, Cyclops is I get, but last episode, if you guys saw that. What? I didn't get it, but apparently they might exist. I've never seen them. I've only heard of Yetis, but maybe snow golems are in this game. But still no update, even though this is one day after recording last episode. I wanted to kind of revisit some of the commentary you guys didn't get. And yeah, still no update. Everybody's kind of looking for one, but there is none. So the sun is setting. You guys can tell it's getting darker, and when it gets darker, it affects the map as well. As you can see, the background of this and anything around it is the color, just like kind of sunset-y color. So it kind of changes your environment as well. Is this a dungeon? This has to be. There's no way this isn't a dungeon. Maybe this isn't. Well, I'm going to climb to the top anyway, even though climbing skill is 0. We are gonna do this, guys. We got this. This is mostly because we started, like, right up at the top. Oh, this is sweet. That's, like, not an official death plateau, but it's still really high. Our climbing skill is awful, so it takes us a while to regen our stuff back. But let's check out this view. And there's a bush up here. Awesome. Just plant fiber. Dang it. Wow, look at this, man. I would hang glide off of this. See a couple of leaves blowing in the distance, and You ever see any of those? Those are. So you can just kind of shoot this in there. But those little lights are campfires. So you can kind of tell where those are if you're at a high place and you need some. Because I know I did a couple times this season and last season. I needed a campfire, and I was like, where the heck is a campfire? But I eventually found one. I think you guys remember that episode. But, man, that troll last episode. Goodness gracious, guys. Whoops. Didn't mean to do that. I was gonna use our healing stream, but then I mean, both of them heal you. So, it doesn't really matter. Damage! Nice, 5 XP, that's not bad. We're leveling up a little slower now, and possibly soon it might be time to head into some easier blue or white level dungeons, like those catacombs, just because, you know, we're going to be needing to level up even more. So yeah, flies, come on guys. Oh, there's a lot of them. Let's kite them all together. All that damage just killed him. Nice. That was a lot of XP, actually. Just got 8 XP from that. Nice. Not bad at all. Let's see. Lights over here. I think that's a campfire. But if you guys do see lights moving, those can also be other creatures. But not all creatures have them. So you gotta be kind of on the lookout for that. At night, there's nothing special. We need those cobwebs as well. We've been gathering resources like crazy. Soon we should have a lot of stuff to work with. And as you guys heard, that owl, those owls, signify the main transition into night. So we are definitely in the big nighttime phase. No, you don't. No, you don't. Nice. Even though they only get 1 XP, I would say they're good for the. They are good for the. Just the cotton. Cotton. I just read that. Copper. They're good for the copper they drop, so they're just basically money makers. You do eventually get way too much money. I need to do that. You eventually do get way too much money to know what to do with, but we're obviously not in that phase now. There's a little mini cave here. Is that a bat? No. Man, no minerals, huh? So hard fighting the bats. Well, at least the first time it was. Actually, those are better than what we have. Oh, wait, what? HP. Oh, the armor is the same, but it gives better stats. That's what I was looking at the armor rating to go up, and I'm like, what the balls? But I know what the deal is with that. Alright, so those are good. Those are some decent better boots that give us better overall stats. That's always what you want to look for. That's always what you want to look for with other items. So, let's just keep on going. Oh, hi, turtle. I'm actually going to kill him. Oh my gosh! Holy crap! Holy balls! I'm going to use my one attack. Wow, that turtle, man, he was going ham on me, man. Holy crap. And then they just knock you down, and they're just going ham on you. I just wanted to, yeah, they do have sometimes a chance of dropping their own item, so that's why I was looking at that. Now, is that a canyon area to my left? Could be. Don't know if we want to explore it yet, but maybe in the near future. Let's keep on going, giving you guys a feel of the night episode of of our night journeys. Let's get to the top of this, man. I always feel like night is a lot cooler when you can fly above it. If you have a hang glider, just fly right over it, and it's amazing. It's amazing looking. Any aspect of this game is just, and its graphics are just so awesome. It's harder to see here at night, but just look at us, man. Look at this, just the mage on the top of the world. I think it's cooler when he's holding his staff. It gets all dark. Man, I have to say, being a mage is not bad. A lot of people say that the ranged characters are harder. I would say that too. He is a little harder to get used to. The ranger is definitely the hardest to level up. It's not the best class, people say, but you know, maybe someday we'll find ourselves playing one. And I think they're gonna plan to introduce new classes soon, so that'd be awesome. Is there anything cool? In this season, there's something I plan to find. And I want to find a portal, because teleporting between worlds would be awesome. But I've only found a portal on a server. I haven't found a portal anywhere else. Oh, they're all physical. I might be able to do this. I'm waiting for somebody to attack me. Oh, balls. No, no, no. One. Ah. Get off me, dude. And where was the other stuff? Just more copper. That's okay. We're actually getting better at that. Those guys were a little easier to take out. That was actually kind of close, but that one attack, man, that saves you. I'll tell you. How many heart flowers do we have? 50. That was our last one. We have yet to smelt up that iron. Man, we are just collecting the resources like a boss. Man, look at this night. Oh, it's so cool. I just love every aspect of the graphics in this game. They are amazing. And I think it was Wally's wife that... I should have known that I was already full up. I think it was Wally's wife that... came or that did the art style for this, because currently it's just him and his wife doing the game, and that's the way it's been. That's why it's taken about a year for the update to come out, but I think this update is going to bring great success to the game. Alright, got more mushroom spit. Here's a bush. And this is just collecting resources. But you know what, guys? I think I'm gonna head on back to, or start heading back to town to craft up the rest of our items. And then, I'll reset it today, get some new quests that we might check out, not sure yet, just because, you know, not sure if we're ready for that kind of thing based on those catacombs. But I do plan on, just going, next episode's gonna be our killing episode. We're gonna continue fighting everything we can, leveling up our character, all that good stuff. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode of Cube World. Hang on, we got a lizard man fight. Somehow everything always manages to interrupt my outros. How rude. Oh, that was fancy. Wow, wow, look at you. All right, well, I'm gonna eat that to heal. And yeah, I'm gonna head on back to town. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. Showing off the nighttime. We won't do too many of these just because, you know, it's kind of like a one-time thing, but it gets very dark. But I also think it's a whole nother world at night to be able to play it. Oh, gosh! Holy crap, that scared me so bad. Oh, my gosh. Okay. Is that thing still following me? Yes, okay, that's creepy at night. I'm just gonna keep running, and I'm gonna hope I don't... I'm gonna hope I don't run into any more enemy. Oh, gosh, dang it! Nope, just kill me, please. Please. Holy crap. Those skulls can stop it right now. Okay, I think that is definitely a time to end off the episode. I'm not gonna move. I'm gonna end off the episode right here, guys. Okay, hopefully you guys enjoyed that episode. If you did, always remember to leave a like. I'm Zombie Gaming MC, and I'll see you guys next time.